In this packet tracer example, we will configure EIGRP on Cisco routers. Here, we will use the topology on the screen consist of 4 routers and 4 PCs. The IP configurations has already done with the given IP addresses on the screen. Now let's start our Cisco EIGRP configuration example. Firstly, we will enable EIGRP with autonomous system number. Here, autonomous system is 100. To do this, we will use router EIGRP 100 command. Then we will add each network connected to this router to EIGRP process. To do this, we will use network command with the network address of that network. Router 0 has 3 interfaces, and each interface is a specific network. So we will add each of these networks to under EIGRP process. We can also use wildcard masks of the networks according to the need. EIGRP automatically advertises summary routes to other EIGRP routers by default. To prevent this, we have used no auto summary command. Lastly, we save our EIGRP configuration. Now, let's configure router 1 for EIGRP. Again, we will use autonomous number 100 to create EIGRP process, and we will add the each connected networks under this EIGRP process. After entering this command, EIGRP neighborship has established because we have already configured the other end. Let's verify our EIGRP configuration. We can use show IP EIGRP neighbors and show IP EIGRP interfaces commands. Our EIGRP neighbor is here. And here are the EIGRP interfaces of this router, the interfaces that we have added under EIGRP process. We can also use show IP protocols command to see EIGRP details. On router 2, we will configure also passive interfaces. We will do this after enabling EIGRP and adding the networks under it. What is passive interface? Passive EIGRP interfaces are the interfaces that are not send or process EIGRP hellos. This prevents EIGRP from forming adjacencies on that interface. Here, we will use passive interface default command to set all the interfaces as passive interface on this router. Then, with no passive interface fast Ethernet 5/0 command, we will activate one of these ports for EIGRP process. Here, we will activate fast Ethernet 5/0 interface. So an EIGRP neighborship will be established on this interface. Let's check EIGRP neighbors and interfaces with EIGRP show commands. Our EIGRP neighbor is here. This is the only active port on this router for EIGRP. Lastly, we will configure router 3 for EIGRP. Again, we can check neighbors and interfaces for EIGRP process. And we can also check routing table for EIGRP routes. The routes expressed with D are EIGRP routes. With show IP route EIGRP command, we can also see only this route. We can check EIGRP topology table with show IP IGRP topology command. We have finished our EIGRP configuration. Now it is time to verify this EIGRP config. To do this, we will ping other PCs from PC0. Firstly, let's remember their IP addresses. Ping to router 1 is successful. Ping to router 2 is successful. Ping to router 3 is successful. We can also check routing tables on each of these routers to see EIGRP routes. Lastly, let's verify one of the routes of EIGRP with traceroute command. Here, we can verify the last route with traceroute command. In other words, we can check the next hop to go that network. To do this, we will use traceroute command with the destination network. As you can see, packets follows the next hop that is mentioned on EIGRP route. We have finished our Cisco EIGRP configuration. In this packet tracer EIGRP example, you have learned how to configure Cisco routers for EIGRP. EIGRP is an important routing protocol. So this configuration will be very useful for you. Till next video, good luck.